Support WrestleTalk!
Give us a subscribe.
This weekend, SmackDown Live presents Clash of Champions, a show that feels more like a pain in the proverbial rather than an actual Clash of Champions. WWE are in their lull season, a period around the holidays where they phone a lot of stuff in while waiting for the new year so they can get excited for the Royal Rumble. What this means is that this weekend's show has barely any build around it, with the exception of the main event. What was the build for Baron Corbin defending his United States Championship against Bobby Roode and Dolph Ziggler? Aside from Corbin and Roode clashing, the match was just announced online. Why is Ziggler in the match? AJ Styles is defending the WWE Championship against Jinder Mahal, just because. Same for the Women's Championship, randomly a lumberjack match, and the tag team titles. Hey, we've got four teams. Just have them beat each other on TV every week so no one gets over, and boom, we've got a pay-per-view match. The only other match on the card which has had any sort of build, arguably most of 2017, is Mojo Rawley versus Zack Ryder, and that's on the pre-show. But this video isn't here to talk about the undercard for Clash of Champions. I want to talk about the main event. Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are taking on Shinsuke Nakamura and Randy Orton, with Shane McMahon and Daniel Bryan as special guest referees, where Sami and Kevin will be fired if they lose. It's a big match with some high-stakes stipulations, and sure to be a fun one due to the storyline going in. However, there is one major problem with said storyline, and it's one I can't quite get my head around. Sami's issues with Shane McMahon have been going on since Hell in a Cell. Sami turned heel and aligned himself with Owens because Shane was constantly overlooking him as a performer. Kevin, on the other hand, has been feuding with him since before SummerSlam, feeling that Shane was putting him in unwinnable situations during his feud with AJ Styles. They were made to go through matches to qualify for Survivor Series, which they failed to do. Yet Shane added John Cena to Team SmackDown without so much as a "you can't see me." Kevin and Sami tried to interfere in the Survivor Series 5-on-5 elimination match, but failed to achieve anything, with best wrestler in the world Shane McMahon chasing off the heels. But in WWE's world of rewriting history, the story now is that Kevin and Sami cost Team SmackDown the match, leading to Shane putting the best friends in matches with the company's biggest stars, handcuffing them to the ring ropes, and putting their jobs on the line in this Sunday's tag match. Shane McMahon is abusing his power, selfishly using his authority over their heels because he doesn't like them. If Sami and Kevin lose this Sunday, they're out of work in kayfabe. They can't put food on the table for their families or keep a roof over their head. And yet in this storyline, Kevin and Sami are their heels. Now, there's no mistaking that. Sami and Kevin are supposed to be the whiny heels that are being justly punished by Shane McMahon. Hence the Occupy SmackDown segments where they were made to look like unwanted clowns, and babyface commentator Byron Saxton talking about what a great job Shane McMahon is doing as commissioner of the brand. Not only that, but Shane picked two giant babyfaces in Randy Orton and Shinsuke Nakamura to represent SmackDown, and he's siding with them. In WWE's mind, Shane is the good guy in this scenario. You know, power-hungry dictator Shane McMahon. In my review of last week's SmackDown Live, I used the thumbnail "Daniel Bryan heel turn teased," which isn't clickbait, folks, and I talked about the closing segment of the show, where Shane announced himself as the special guest referee after Daniel Bryan asked if he was done punishing Sami and Kevin. I came to the conclusion that Bryan was teasing a heel turn because, should he side with the best friends, he's aligning himself with the heels. Now, a lot of people took me to task over this, arguing that in this storyline, Shane McMahon is the clear heel and I'm a dingleberry for not knowing. Noticing that. Here's the thing, I agree with you. Shane is the clear heel here, but this isn't being presented as a heel versus heel feud. Instead, Shane is a rightful and just babyface. Daniel Bryan is questioning his authority, Randy and Nakamura are super babyfaces, and Kevin and Sami are the dastardly heels who cost SmackDown Live their match and should therefore be fired. Or is it one of those weird cases in this new era of WWE where there are no babyfaces and heels, just characters? John Cena has always said, despite all evidence to the contrary, he was a heel in WWE. His argument is, if you boo me, I'm clearly a heel to you. Triple H has said the same thing about Roman Reigns. All those fans asking for a Roman heel turn, you boo him, he's already a heel for you. Unless you're one of those people who cheer Cena and Reigns, then he's obviously a babyface. People often argue that Steve Austin wasn't a traditional babyface because of the way he acted. But here's the thing. He was booked like a babyface in babyface versus heel feuds. Vince McMahon was a clear heel. The Undertaker was a clear heel. Dude Love was a clear heel. Kane was a clear heel. Austin may not have asked people to say their prayers and eat their vitamins, but he was the babyface in his storyline. And WWE don't book Cena or Reigns to be shades of grey, they book them like babyfaces. And in the case of Clash of Champions, Kevin and Sami have been booked to be their heels. So by de facto, Shane is the babyface. But if Shane is also a heel by design, because the booking certainly makes him look like one, are Orton and Nakamura idiots for believing in Vince McMahon's offspring? Are the heels Kevin and Sami right? Is Byron Saxton just filled with unnatural blind loyalty? Or is it just a terribly told story where the morals are askew? Does WWE have a babyface problem? And what's the true story behind Vince McMahon blowing up? Click the videos to the left to find out more, press subscribe and support WrestleTalk on Patreon. Order the magazine and download the WrestleRamble podcast. I have been Luke Owen, and that was just my opinion.